Guiding Light, History Lesson Number 2. The time is 1980. Bridget and Jerome Dobson have left to go right for As the World Turns, and the infamous Doug Marland comes on board to write for Guiding Light. Now he populates my young Katie world with a lot of other young characters, one of which was Kevin Bacon, who jumped ship fairly early on. He went off to do movies and stuff like that. And I think if I'd been really smart, I probably should have done the same thing to see where my life would go after that. But I had a baby at home, and there was no way I was going to leave a steady gig. So Katie shifted. I polished my halo a lot. And Doug did write some of the more dramatic material for Katie. In 1982, he won for Best, Guiding Light won for Best Show again, and he won for Best Writer. And at the Emmys, I found it kind of interesting because they played a Katie clip, which had no dialogue. It was acting and reacting with Tony. And I just found that kind of interesting. I hope you enjoy this scene. Very dramatic. Enjoy.
Why can't I be attracted to a nice, straightforward, upstanding citizen for once in my life? I'm the worst picker. Look at Mark Hamilton, for instance. Everyone warned me about Mark, didn't they? They were stopping me in the streets to warn me about Mark. Even I could see he was chasing everything in skirts in the hospital. Even Floyd caught on to him. Oh, did that stop me? Oh, no. Not me. Not Katie Parker, no.
Katie, what does he do?
It's not what he does. It's the way he acts. You know, it's all this boyish charm of his suddenly just vanishes, and there's this angry, aggressive, violent man standing before me that seems to have a very, very low opinion of women.
Oh, Katie, I don't like that. That reminds me of someone I was involved with.
Oh, Hillary, I'm sorry. I don't know. Maybe I'm carrying on too much about it. You know what I mean? I'm making more out of it than I should. But 95% of the time, he's wonderful. It's just every now and then.
Look, I'll tell you what. Why don't I go make some coffee, and you could take your shower, and then we could talk, all right? How does that sound?
Great.
Okay, good.
Thanks.
Katie, what happened to you? Where did you get those bruises?
That's just a little reminder of the other 5% of the time when Andy's not so nice.
Did that to you?
Yeah. Don't tell anyone about it, okay?
No, I wouldn't say anything. Oh, Katie, I'm just worried about that.
Yeah, I am too. A little.